In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Greetings, good people of God, and welcome to today's edition of Catholic Meditation. Today is Tuesday, the 24th of August, 2021. It is Tuesday of the 21st week in Ordinary Time, Church Year B. I am Reverend Father Blessed Ambang Njume. The church celebrates the feast day of Saint Bartholomew, Apostle. Good morning and thanks for joining us. Let us pray. Strengthen in us, O Lord, the faith by which the blessed Apostle Bartholomew clung wholeheartedly to your Son, and grant that through the help of his prayers, your church may become for all the nations the sacrament of salvation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. The first reading is taken from the book of Revelation, chapter 21, verses 9 to 14. The responsorial psalm is taken from Psalm 145. The response to the psalm is, "Your saints, O Lord, make known the glory of your reign." The gospel is taken from St. John, chapter 1, verses 45 to 51. I read from the gospel. At that time, Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him of whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." Jesus saw Nathanael coming to him and said of him, "Behold, an Israelite indeed, in whom is no guile." Nathanael said to him, "How do you know me?" Jesus answered him, "Before Philip called you, when you were under the fig tree, I saw you." Nathanael answered him, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered him, "Because I said to you, I saw you under the fig tree, do you believe? You shall see greater things than this." And he said to him, "Truly, truly, I say to you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. The theme for today's meditation is Break down your prejudices and be a reliable person. Break down your prejudices and be a reliable person. Dearly beloved of God, today we celebrate the feast of Saint Bartholomew, Apostle. Of the 12 apostles, he is one among those whom much is not said. We do not hear about them. It may even be hard for some people to recall the name Bartholomew as being one of the apostles. He was a native of Cana in Galilee. He has also been identified as Nathanael, who appears in the Gospel of John, and it was Philip, another apostle, who introduced him to Jesus. After Pentecost, according to tradition, he took the gospel to Armenia, and there he suffered martyrdom. He was skinned alive. In fact, he was the first of the apostles to be martyred. In celebrating his feast today, let us look at two things. First, breaking down our prejudices, and second, being reliable people. Bartholomew had a prejudice of Nazareth. He knew that nothing good could come from Nazareth. It was a prejudice. And so when Philip told him that they had found him, about whom Moses spoke and the prophets wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph, Bartholomew said, from Nazareth? Can anything good come from that place? Now this is a prejudice. Prejudgment. Even before experiencing, he had his prejudgments, and our prejudices block us and prevent us from enjoying persons or places. It could be same with you. You have had your prejudices about some people, and no matter how much they try to impress you, you have been blocked by your prejudices. Or it could just be you suffering from prejudices of other people. When they see you, they have already put you in a certain box, and no matter how much you try to impress them, they can never get you out of that box. Many people suffer from prejudices. Today, beloved, we are challenged to break down our prejudices. Always give people and places a blank sheet. It is said experience is the best teacher. When you listen to stories about people, without experiencing them, you begin to build mental mappings and prejudices about them. You may even be hating people you have never experienced simply because you have built your mental mappings and prejudices. If someone ever told Bartholomew that he would be an apostle of that Jesus who came from Nazareth, a place he thought nothing good could ever come from, he would never have believed. So you see, your best friend may just come from that place you had a prejudice about. Your best friend may just be that one you had prejudices about. Dear friends, break down your prejudices. Break down your mental mappings and experience people for yourself before you conclude. Also, in celebrating today's feast, let us look at the other aspect of being reliable people. Let us pay our attention on the words of Jesus as he used them to describe Bartholomew. We are told when Jesus saw Nathanael coming, he said of him, there truly is an Israelite in whom there is no deception. John chapter 1 verse 47. What would have accounted for such a positive remark from Jesus? What was it about Bartholomew that accounted for such a reputation from the master? By saying or speaking such words of him, Jesus meant Bartholomew is reliable. He is truthful. He cannot hurt a fly. You can count on him. An Israelite incapable of deceit. We know just how well and unreliable the Israelites were. Yet, Jesus saw one on whom he could place trust, on whom he could rely. Dear friends, till date, Jesus still has need of reliable persons.
Can he see you as he saw Bartholomew and say of you, there lies a Christian of whom there is no deceit? Many people have lost reliability. We cannot rely on them anymore. So ask yourself today, how reliable are you? Do your friends rely on you? Can you deliver if reliability is placed on you? Can you be relied on? Can God rely on you? If someone is in need of a trustworthy person, someone they can rely on, can you be shown them or pointed out? Can the church rely on you? Being reliable is one of the most valued traits in a person. Put simply, being reliable means to be trusted. Someone can lean on you in confidence without being failed. Has someone ever told you, I rely on you? There are very strong words, beloved. Now, when something happens, there is no reliable source to trust to get information. They hope to come to you because you are a reliable person. Many times, dear friends, when things happen, we are not so sure of what is true or what is false. People twist stories these days, even media houses. So what is reliable information? How reliable are our sources of information? We cannot trust information these days. Because even when something happens, people begin to twist and tell us things that are not coherent. We have fallen short of reliability. We have fallen short of the score. We have broken trust and confidence. We have not kept our word or side of the bargain. God needs reliable Christians. Can he rely on you to change your family? Can he rely on you to change your office? Can he rely on you to change your society and your world? How many more Bartholomews are there that it could be said of them, there lies a person incapable of deceit? God needs people, but not any kind. He needs reliable people. Tell yourself and God this day that you will be a reliable person. He can rely on you to change the negative mind frame in your office, at home, at work, at school, in your vicinity. Be another Bartholomew. Break down your walls of prejudices, biases, and mental mappings. Experience people and places before you draw your conclusions. You may just be missing out on a blessing because of your prejudices. And truly, many times it has proven true that those whom our prejudices blocked us from experiencing, when we try to open up a little, we just discover how wonderful they are. Dear God, help us with the graces we need, and may we always cooperate with the graces so that we make of ourselves reliable persons that you can use for your purpose. Saint Bartholomew, intercede for us. Amen. We wish a happy feast day to all those who go by the name Bartholomew. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come on you and remain with you forever. Amen.